so an understatement. Foreigners have sold the English talent. On the continent, you find any amount of people who sigh deeply for no conspicuous reason. Yearn, suffer, and look in the air extremely sadly. This is souls. The worst kind of soul is the great sloth soul. People who suffer from it are usually very good thinkers. They may say things like this. Sometimes I'm so merry, and sometimes I'm so sad. Can you explain why you cannot do not try? Or they may say, I'm so mysterious. I sometimes wish I were somewhere else than where I am. Do not say how I wish you were. Or when I'm in a forest, at night time, and jump from one tree to another, I often feel that life is so strange. All this is very deep, and just soul, nothing else. The English have no soul. They have the understatement instead. If a continental youth once declares his love to a girl, he kneels down, tells her that she is the sweetest, the most charming and ravishing person in the world, that she has something in her, something peculiar and individual, which only a few hundred thousand other men have, and that he would be unable to save one more minute without her. Often, to give a little more emphasis to the statement, he shoots himself on the spot. This is a normal weekday declaration of love in the more temperamental continental countries. In England, the boy passes a bottle on the back and says softly, I don't object to you, you know. Or if he's quite mad with passion, he may add, I rather fancy you, in fact. If he wants to marry a girl, he says, I say, would you? Or if he wants to make an indecent proposal, I say, what about? Overstatement too plays a considerable part in English social life. This takes mostly the form of someone remarking, I say, and then keeping silent for 3 days and a half. How to be a hypocrite? If you want to be really and truly British, you must become a hypocrite. Now, how to be a hypocrite? As some people say, that an example can explain things better than the best theory. Let me try this way. I had a drink with an English friend of mine in a pub. We were sitting on the high chairs in front of the counter when a flying bomb exploded about 100 yards away. I was truly and honestly frightened. A few seconds later, when I looked around, I couldn't see my friend anywhere. At last, I noticed he was lying on the floor flat as a pancake. When he realized that nothing particular had happened in the pub, he got up, a little embarrassed, flicked the dust off his suit, and turned to me with a superior and sarcastic smile. Good heavens! Were you so frightened that you couldn't move? Thank you very much.